everybody, I am Liz from French Toasts and Books, and today I'm going to be talking about 10 books where my thoughts and feelings are very much in conflict and turmoil about how I want to rate it and how much I either enjoyed or didn't enjoy the book. And so I'm going to get right started with the first book, which happens to be The Fifth Wave by Rick Yancey. I just finished this book. It's marketed as a sci-fi alien invasion YA type story, and for the most part that's what it is, but I'm not quite sure how I feel about it. I am so conflicted right now because I love the characters, I love the plot, I love the journey of the characters. It reads more of like a survival story, which is totally fine and I get it, but the main thing, this is the fifth wave. There are four previous waves of this alien invasion that have wreaked havoc on Earth, have decimated the Earth population, and have put all of these people, even children, in survival mode. And as much as I love this, I have a really huge problem with the aliens in this story. If you've read this book, you know what I'm talking about, possibly. I'm not going to get into spoiler territory with this book because some of you may or may not have read it, may or may not have watched the movie yet. Though the writing itself was great to listen to as I paired up the audiobook with the physical copies I read, it doesn't sit well when you're actually physically reading the book because the sentences are very short and repetitious, and it leads a little disorienting when you're reading it versus listening to it on audio. I really do love the characters and the journey of the story and the overall plot line, the romance elements, the love story-esque type things in the book I'm also really okay with. I felt that the characters were very reminiscent of their ages, which is an issue I have in a lot of books. But like I said, it didn't really read like a sci-fi alien invasion story for me, and that is a big pitfall, I guess, of the story, to where I'm not quite sure how I feel. And so please let me know if you read this book and kind of your thoughts and feelings in this book on the comments down below, because I really kind of need to talk about it and sort out my feelings, because I am so conflicted with the story and whether or not I should move on with the sequel. The next book we're gonna go with is from one of my favorite authors, and that is A History Is All You've Left Me by Adam Silvera. I love Adam Silvera's stories and their ability to elicit so many sad emotions, happy emotions, and how I cried through literally almost this entire book, if not sobbing the first half of the book. It was such an emotional roller coaster for me, as it takes place with this boy's ex and first love has died, and so he's dealing with the funeral and this week of mourning while also remembering, and we're getting transported into the past for their relationship and friendship. And so it's a really heartfelt story. So I definitely love the characters and the plot and everything and the premise, but my issue lied in a few character choices that really kind of distracted me from the story, because I felt that possibly this is an actual reality for some people that are mourning, but I just wasn't feeling it. It kind of made the plot expectations I had for the story, especially because I had already loved Adam Silvera's More Happy Than Not story so much, that I was just so conflicted while reading the book, at least the second half of the story, and so I'm still kind of reconciling my feelings of the story. Next we have We Were Liars by E. Lockhart. This is a story that you want to go into basically knowing nothing of the plot, other than it is a family, a close-knit group of friends that are wealthy. They own an island, and all we can tell from the main character is something happened in the past, and we're just kind of figuring it out along with the ride with the character and learning about all of these inner family workings. So I really enjoyed the characters and I really enjoyed the mystery and figuring it out, because I never actually figured it out until the big reveal at the end. But my issue with this story really lied in the writing. I had a hard time following along, especially in the introduction, the prologue, and the first three chapters. It jumped around and the sentences didn't quite make sense, and so it really distracted me from the story. And I just had to, after reading it a couple times and still not quite understanding, I had to just keep going. And eventually I kind of understood E. Lockhart's little musings and writings and quirks, and I finally ended up liking this story. Next, we have one that BookTube loves so, so much, and that is Dreams of Gods and Monsters by Lainey Taylor. This is the third book in her Daughter of Smoke and Bone series, the final book, the like end all of this amazing fantasy story with Karu, and I absolutely loved books two and the first one so much. I love the romance and this battle story as it evolved into war. I super enjoyed it, and I had such high expectations for this book, but the ending was so not what I wanted. It didn't feel like a conclusion. It didn't feel wrapped up. It felt like it introduced this whole huge aspect that I wanted more of, and so I was very disappointed to know that that was how Lainey Taylor wanted to end her series. Next up, we have another BookTube favorite, which is Fangirl by Rainbow Rowell. This one also had my issue being with the ending. Particularly, I just felt that it was rushed and it didn't like feel like a completed story. I wanted so much more for the main character than what ended up actually happening, but I loved her journey as it was her first year in college. She has a lot of family problems, a lot of issues, and she's really trying to figure that out while trying to be an adult, trying to take care of herself and finish her fan fiction story, as she writes fan fiction for a very popular book series that's reminiscent of Harry Potter. However, that also leads to another issue I had in the book itself, where each chapter started off with a little excerpt line either from the fan fiction or from the actual story that it is, the fan fiction's based off of. I spent a lot of time while reading the chapter trying to see if the little excerpt tied into the chapter at all or would have a reveal, and so it distracted me from the ultimate purpose of each chapter and the story. Next up, I'm just gonna be spouting a lot of BookTube favorites, and I'm so sorry guys, but next up we have Aristotle and Dante Discover the Secrets of the Universe by Benjamin Sines. I love the characters, the development, the plot of the story and everything, but this one, the writing was just not for me. I thought it was going to be more of a narration, but I think it was more lettering, and I remember starting it on audiobook and just getting too confused. Like, it was just too jumpy, and so I had to actually cut the audio and just sit down and read, which helped, but I still had this kind of unsettling feeling with the writing as I read the story, and that's why I haven't really picked up any of Benjamin Sines' other books, even though I've also heard so many great things about them. Next, we have a story that I thought I would love. Like, I thought I would hands down love this story so much. It was recommended from an amazing BookTuber, April Sarah, and that is Etiquette and Espionage by Gail Carriger. I thought I would absolutely adore this book series because it's steampunk. I wanted to get more introduced to steampunk novels because I thought I would love it. This book, though I did enjoy much of the plot and learning about these characters, it just took me a long time to get there because some of the details were lacking in the story, which made me confuse side characters, especially with their confusing names and their personalities. I also felt that some of them were very immature, particularly the main character, and that made me very hesitant to read the sequel, and I still haven't picked it up yet, which is sad disservice because it's steampunk, there's fantasy elements with werewolves, vampires, and all that other stuff. I thought I would love it personally, and I am just so conflicted by how I feel with the story and if I should continue on. The next one I have is Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children by Ransom Riggs. I had such high hopes for this story because of the pictures, the premise, the plot, everything. I was so stoked. I went in this gung-ho and so excited to dive into this book and look at the creepy pictures and everything like that. But the romance in the story was just not my thing, and it totally distracted me from my enjoyment of the story. I felt that this book could have been written so much better if you would have just removed the romance. I actually would have had this feeling, this inclination to continue on, and I don't feel that way, and it's just very disappointing and conflicting, and I'm just so sad and disappointed. Next, we have Amulet, book one, called The Stonekeeper by Kazuo Kibayashi. I absolutely thought I was gonna adore this book because of the premise and the art, because it is a comic series. I thought I would love it, but then I go in and they have this kind of chosen one plot aspect of this teenage girl, and then we have this other plot in this story about them rescuing their mother. Things just by the end fell very flat for me, even though I felt like I was so hardcore going to love it. And so I have so much mixed feelings and conflict with this story. And I mean, I absolutely adore everything about this. It's so beautiful, and so I am so conflicted of whether or not I should continue on with this story, just because I'm not sure I'm going to enjoy the plot. Alright guys, we have the last book that I'm talking about, book 10, which is another fairly BookTube favorite that I thought I was going to love and enjoy, and that's Station 11 by Emily St. John Mandel. I was so stoked for this post-parasitic plague world of a survival story with a traveling Shakespearean play act. They're surviving and they're also trying to bring joy to other people. There's a lot of stuff going on in the background, and I did enjoy that. I just felt like the actual book plot didn't really hold up to the premise or the summary of the story on the back of the cover, and so I really struggled reading this book. This book also jumps around in time from pre-plague, during the plague, and then post of the plague, so I got really confused on the storylines, or I got really invested in one storyline and not invested in another, and so it was so hard for me to read this book and really enjoy it to the fullest that I wanted to. So there we have these stories. I am so conflicted about. Do you guys have this issue, this conflict in your inner heart and soul when you read a book and you find that something just doesn't sit well with you? Please let me know if you have any of those thoughts and feelings for any of the books I mentioned here in this video, or if you have one that you just finished, or that something that really pops in your mind that you're conflicted about. Let's talk about it down in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed this video and that you don't hate on me too much for my thoughts and opinions on these books, especially if they're your favorite. I understand that my thoughts and feelings and opinions are different from yours. I hope to see you guys next time, as I will be posting a video on Wednesday, come hell or high water. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I love you guys. Bye!